Every year, we celebrate our country's independence on 15th August. We remember our great leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, Chandrasekhar Azad, Bhagat Singh, Lala Lajpat Rai, and many others. But more often, most of us ignore the earlier leaders who equally fought with the British for our freedom, like Jhansi Lakshmi Bhai, Nana Sahib, Tatya Tope, Begum Hazrat Mahal, Kunbar Singh, Maulvi Abdullah, and so on. Welcome, listeners. This is Giridhar, and you are listening to the podcast Giridhar's Garady. Before we proceed with the episode today, let's take a look at the comments from the last episode. The first comment was from Umera. She says, "Nice sir, awesome move." Thank you, Umera. The next comment was from Ashutosh. He says, "The first episode is good." Thank you, Ashutosh. Alright, on the occasion of our Independence Day, I am here with the theme 1857 Revolt, the first war of independence. This episode provides you an insight on how the British colonized India, who were the then leaders, what they did, and how they were the major driving force for the historical event 1857 Revolt, which is also called the First War of Independence. The British entered India in 1600s, when India was under the rule of Jahangir. They were contented to be traders, as India was a stronger nation back then. Initially, they reached Surat, after that Malabar, and then Madras. Their next target was Bengal, wherein they had to deal with the stubborn king Sirajuddaula. Colonel Robert Clyde from the British took the help of Sirajuddaula's minister Mir Jafar, with a promise that the king's throne would be given to his son if he helps the British in defeating Sirajuddaula. Thus, the British defeated the Bengal king in the Battle of Plassey, which opened them the new doors to India. Their principle was always very simple: divide and rule. They used to involve two Indians into a combat and take advantage of that. If such things doesn't work, they used to bribe one Indian to go against the other. It's not only between two common people, but also between two large kingdoms they were successful in getting a battle started. For instance, Tipu Sultan, the Tiger of Mysore, resisted the East India Company's conquest of southern India. However, as per the British plot, the Nizam of Hyderabad and Marathas surrounded the Mysore kingdom when British attacked Tipu Sultan. Later, even the Anglo-Maratha War took place, in which the Marathas were defeated. Apart from all this, the British developed religion differences among Indians. Slowly, steadily, they established political control over India. To brief about the leaders in 19th century, let me start with Jhansi Lakshmi Bai. In her childhood itself, she was intelligent enough to understand the actions of British. She never had great thoughts about building up her life and family, but all she thought was what she can do for the country. The time when she noticed that her direct actions against British resulted in unexpected consequences, she started doing everything in disguise. She gave herself another name called Kranti Guru. She burned the British flag in response to their action when they insulted and tortured the Indians. She even burned all their documents when they started collecting tax from Indian farmers unnecessarily. She released all the Indian prisoners who got arrested by the British without any proper reasons. All this happened when she was in Bittur, staying with her father Moropan Tambe, who was a pandit in the Bittur court of Peshwa Bajirao. Nana Sahib supported Lakshmi Bai in going against British. Both of them had a common teacher, Tatya Tope, who was an expert in the sword fights. In fact, he played a major role in inspiring Lakshmi Bai whenever she felt helpless. Then we had Begum Hazrat Mahal, who was the first wife of Nawab Wajid Ali Shah, the Nawab of Awadh. She was also a strong fighter to go against British during their demolition of temples and mosques to make way for the roads. We even have a park named after her as Begum Hazrat Mahal Park in Hazrat Ganj, Lucknow. And Kunwar Singh, who was from Jagdishpur, Bihar, was an expert in the art of guerrilla warfare. His tactics left the British puzzled. If we look at the reasons for the 1857 revolt, there were many. The annexionist policies of the British, especially doctrine of lapse proposed by Lord Dalhousie, which states that any particular state or kingdom would be annexed by the British if there is no male heir or successor. It made all Indian rulers develop hatred towards British. The British even exported the Indian resources to London to promote British industries. Consequently, the country had to face poverty, as traditional handicrafts and industries were ruined. Even a way to impose their religion on Indians was unacceptable to a major extent. Apart from all this, the Indian soldiers who worked for British were ill-treated in several ways and were even sent to other countries like China, Iran to fight wars of the English. Also, a rumor that the cartridges supplied by the East India Company to the soldiers in its army contained pork or beef fat was objectionable to Muslims and Hindus, which was also said to be an immediate cause of the revolt. The revolt was started by a sepoy, Mangal Pandey, who killed senior British officers on parade in Bengal. Slowly, the revolt spread to other places like Meerut, Delhi, Kanpur, Lucknow, Jhansi and Bareilly. Lakshmi Bai led the revolt in Jhansi when the British refused to accept the claim of her adopted son Damodar Rao to the throne of Jhansi. However, she was defeated and latter had to join Tatya Tope, through which she was able to capture Gwalior. She fought with the British like a tigress and died fighting till her end, after which Gwalior was recaptured by the British. Nana Sahib led the revolt in Kanpur as the British stopped giving pension to him after his father's death, claiming that he was not a natural born heir to Bajirao Peshwa. Although he tried sending his representative Azimullah Khan to England to plead his case, things didn't work out. He captured Kanpur and claimed himself the Peshwa. However, in a very short span, the British recaptured Kanpur and the rebels were either hanged or imprisoned. Nana Sahib escaped, but Tatya Tope continued the struggle, after which even he was defeated, arrested and hanged. Begum Hazrat Mahal was the leader of the revolt in Lucknow, which she seized with the help of soldiers from the old Awadh army, and declared her son Birjis Quadra as the ruler, but the British captured Lucknow and she escaped to Nepal. Kunwar Singh was the leader of the revolt in Bihar. Even at the time of 80 years, he was powerful enough to fight with the British. He occupied Ara and during the recapture from British, he had to cut off one of his hands due to risk of infection through a bullet shot. Then he occupied Azamgarh and latter died. His brother Amar Singh continued the revolt. Bahadur Shah Jafar was declared the Emperor of Hindustan and he led the revolt in Delhi. However, he was arrested towards the end of the revolt. Even after having so many great leaders, the revolt failed. due to lack of enough participation from people all over the country. Thereby, lack of resources like men, money and weapons. This was because the people of India were not still inspired by the spirit of independence by that time. Also, the revolt was not a planned one, it was spontaneous. Even the arms used were inferior to the arms of the English. Whatever the reasons it can be, the revolt was not ignorable and it marked its own place in the history of India. To include my personal experience, I used to watch the show 1857 Kranti during my childhood days. Although it's been close to 20 years, I'm able to remember few of the acts like the sword fight between Lakshmibai and Nana Sahib under the guidance of Tatya Tope, Begum Hazrat Mal's association with Nana Sahib on Raksha Bandhan, the way Nana Sahib brutally kills the English soldiers on his return from Jhansi, the way Lakshmibai turns against the British when they oppose her son to the throne of Jhansi. All this just inspired me and I used to wait for a week to watch the show again in those days. Now it is available on YouTube and I strongly recommend you to give a watch. The final note here is, we all are one people in spite of our diversity. And we must remember that we should maintain our unity no matter what our region and religion be. The leaders and soldiers of 1857 revolt came together to fight for the nation, keeping aside all the other aspects. Even it's time for us to think what we can do for our country. A penny for your thoughts. Here comes the end of our sixth episode, 1857 revolt. I will be back with another amazing concept next week. For now, good hafiz.